So there are three things that you are going to learn from this video. First and foremost, what are the different types of placenta previa? And the second thing is, what is dangerous placenta previa? And third thing is, what is Stallworthy sign? So these are the three important high yield points I'm going to cover from this video. So let us start our discussion with the types of placenta previa. So what is placenta previa? The abnormal location of placenta. That is, the placenta is located either very near to the internal os, or it is located over the internal os. So this is placenta previa. So there are four types of placenta previa. When I say types, there are other terminology also. Some says degrees of placenta previa, and some says types of placenta previa, and some even says the stages of placenta previa. So all are synonyms. You can say degree, you can say stage, or you can say a type of placenta previa. So I'll because in the image I have given it as a degree, I'm mentioning it as the first degree, second degree, third degree, and also the fourth degree placenta previa. So the first degree is low lying placenta. So in this degree 1 or first degree, instead of placenta being implanted in the upper uterine segment, it is reaching the lower uterine segment. So the placenta is implanted in the lower uterine segment, but the placental edge, whatever you see here, it is not reaching the internal os, but it is in close proximity to the internal os, but it is not reaching the internal os. If it reaches the edge, if the edge of the placenta, if it reaches the margin of the internal os, then we call it as second degree, or we also call it as marginal placenta previa. So the second degree is marginal placenta previa. The first degree is low lying placenta. Then the stage 3 or third degree placenta previa, what it is? In this, the internal os is partially covered by, actually just it rolls over the internal os. The placental edge rolls over the internal os, or the internal os is partially covered by the placenta. So this is third degree, or we call it as partial placenta previa. And when I say fourth degree, it is completely covered by the placenta, and the placenta crosses over the internal os. It is also present on the lower uterine segment of the opposite side. And we call it as total placenta previa. So these are the types of placenta previa: low lying, marginal, partial, and total. So after understanding this, let us get back to the question here. So the question is, what is dangerous placenta previa? So out of all this, this is first degree, this is second degree, this is third degree, and this is fourth degree placenta. Instead of giving these options, the examiner can also give the first stage, second or third or fourth stage. So which type of placenta previa is dangerous, and why it is dangerous? The answer here is marginal placenta previa. The marginal placenta previa, whenever it is implanted on the posterior uterine wall. See, this is a two-dimensional image, but just imagine this placenta is spread over the posterior wall of the uterine segment. If this is the posterior wall, if it is on the posterior uterine wall, then we call it as dangerous placenta previa. So second degree or marginal placenta previa, when it is located on the posterior uterine wall, then it is known as dangerous placenta previa. Why it is called dangerous? We all know that the placenta has a thickness of about 2.5 centimeters. So let's say if it is the sacral bone, and if this is the uterine segment, and if this is the posterior uterine wall, if the placenta is located on the posterior wall close to the sacral promontory, what happens? There is a thickness of 2.5 centimeters lying in front of the sacral promontory. And this this is how the head should pass, the fetal head should pass down, right? Because of this excess placental tissue now, the anterior posterior diameter of the birth canal, that is the pelvic inlet, it is compromised because of this placental thickness. And this will prevent the engagement of the fetal placental part. Hope you're getting my point. Let me revise it again. Because of the marginal placenta previa localization on the posterior uterine wall, because it has a thickness of 2.5 centimeters, it is compromising the pelvic inlet. So because of that, the engagement of the fetal presenting part is affected. Because it is not taking place, because the engagement is not taking place, there will not be effective compression of the placenta at the time of delivery. We all know the placenta needs effective compression to control the bleeding. Because the engagement doesn't take in place, the placenta, it bleeds profusely. So there will be vaginal bleeding which cannot be controlled because of this localization. So that's the reason this kind of a PPH, postpartum hemorrhage, is very high. And that is the reason we call this marginal placenta previa, which is lying on the posterior uterine wall, as the dangerous placenta previa. And there is one important sign with the help of which you can diagnose this dangerous placenta previa. What is that sign? As I told you at the start of our discussion, we are going to cover 3 points. And the third important high yield point here is Stallworthy sign. So what is this sign? See, the baby fetal head is lying onto the placenta, right? So in dangerous placenta previa, whenever the head is pushed back into the pelvis, so this is a maneuver. When you're trying to push the head back into the pelvis, this is going to compress the placenta and also placental circulation. In turn, it also compresses the umbilical cord, which is attached to the placenta. So this umbilical cord compression, whenever you are moving the head into the pelvic inlet, this leads to fetal distress. And this will cause slowing of heart rate of the fetus, that is the bradycardia. So this sign is known as Stallworthy sign. So what is your take home? Stallworthy sign is a sign which helps in diagnosing marginal placenta previa. And what do we do in Stallworthy sign? We push the head back into the pelvic inlet. When on doing so, because of the compression of the umbilical cord, there will be bradycardia in the fetus. So these are the three important things what we covered from this video. One is types of placenta, other is what is dangerous placenta previa, and third important thing is what is Stallworthy sign.